Hello students, welcome back. In today's class we shall discuss about network analysis. So network analysis is a technique that is used for planning and scheduling large projects in the field of constructions, maintenance, fabrications, etc. The network analysis plays an important role in project management, students. This technique is used to minimize the interruptions, delays, cost to complete the project on time by determining the critical factors and coordinating various parts of the overall job. So students, network is nothing but a graphical representation of all the activities and events of a project arranged in a logical and sequential order. So there are two basic planning and controlling techniques that utilize a network to complete a predetermined project or schedule. So the two techniques are, number one is critical path method and the next one is program evaluation review techniques, that is PERT and CPM. Okay. So here the critical path method is a technique for planning, scheduling and controlling of a project whose activities not subject to any uncertainty and the performance times are fixed. So in that situation, the CPM method is used. And next, the PERT technique is used for planning, scheduling and controlling of a project whose activities are subject to uncertainty in the performance time. Okay. At that situation, PERT is used. The CPM is used when there is no uncertainty and the performance time is also fixed. The PERT technique is used where the project is subject to some uncertainty in the performance time. Clear everyone, students? So these are the two techniques that are used in network analysis. To understand the network analysis, one should be familiar with a few basic terms that are used in both CPM and PERT. So the first one is network. So network is nothing but, students, it is a graphical representation of logically and sequentially connected arrows and nodes representing activities and events of a project. Okay. So here arrows and nodes are nothing but the activities and events of a project. So networks are also called arrow diagrams, students. Clear? So the next term that is used, that is activity. Activities is nothing but the actual performance of a job. So in network diagram, the activities are represented by arrow. Okay, so the activities are represented by arrow and each activity is started and ended with an event. Clear? And these events are represented by a circle. Clear, students? So the activity is represented by an arrow and events are represented by a circle, and the activity should start and end with an events. Clear? An activity represents some action and is a time consuming effort necessary to complete a particular part of the overall project. So it is represented by an arrow, students. Every activity starts and end with an events or nodes. So here these two circles are events or nodes, and this is an activity, that a here is an activity. Okay. And the next term is, students, dummy activity. So here there will be certain events which neither consumes time nor resources but are used simply to represent a connection or a link between the events are known as dummies or dummy activity. Okay, students. So here when two or more activities in a project have the same event, then the dummy activity is used. So it is shown in network by a dotted line. These dummy activities are represented by a dotted line. For example, the dummy activity is represented by this dotted line in the form of an arrow. Okay, so this is an dummy activity. Clear everyone, students? So these are the basic terms that are used in network analysis. So next important terms that are used in CPM and PERT are, number one is earliest starting time, that is EST, is nothing but the earliest possible time when an activity can begin, that is known as EST. Next one is earliest finishing time, is nothing but EST plus activity time, is known as earliest finishing time. Okay. So the formula of calculating EFT is EST plus activity time. Next one is latest finishing time. It's nothing but the target time for completing a project, that is known as LFT. And next is latest starting time. It's nothing but LFT, that is latest finishing time minus activity time. So this is the formula that is used to calculate the latest starting time. Okay. In network diagram, students, these two we need to find out, that is earliest starting time and next latest finishing time by using the backward pass compute calculation and forward pass calculation. Okay, so the next is float. Float is also known as slack, students. Slack or float is same. Slack or float is nothing but the difference between earliest and latest event time is known as float or slack. So here the total float is calculated. The formula to calculate the total float is LST minus EST, that is latest starting time minus earliest starting time will get the total float. And next, to compute the free float, the formula is EFT minus LFT minus total float. Okay, so here EFT is earliest finishing time minus latest finishing time of minus total float. Okay, students, these are the formulas that are used in computation of per time. CPM will better understand this concept by doing a problem. Okay, this is the question number one. The activities and time in weeks is given. So these are the activities, students, and the time is also given. To do 1 to 2 activity, the time taken is 10 weeks. To 1 to 3 activities, the time taken is 24 weeks and so on. Okay, they are asking us to draw a network diagram and determine the critical path and project completion time. Clear? So first we shall draw a network diagram. Based on the activities, we shall draw the diagram. So first activity is 1 to 2, and again from 1 the second activities is coming, and next from again from 1 the third activity is also coming. So I'm taking the first activity, first event, that is 1 to 2 and 1 to 3. The two activities are coming from 1. So 1 to 2. Next 1 to 3. Okay. So for 1 to 2 activity, the time taken is 10 weeks. Okay. Next for 1 to 3, the time is 24 weeks. Clear? Next from 2 to 3, next activity is 2 to 3. Okay, again 2 to 4. From 2, third and fourth activity is coming. So 2 to 3, that is 2 to 3. Next 2 to 4. Okay, for 2 to 3 activity, the duration time is 9. For 2 to 4, it is 16. Clear? Next, 2 to 5. Again from 2, there is 5. Fifth activity. So, fifth. Okay. Next, this is 2 to 5. It takes 10 weeks. Clear? Next, 3 to 5. So 3 to 5, I am connecting these two events. The duration is 9. Next, 4 to 5, connect these two. The duration is 4. And next, from 5, the last activity is 6. Okay. 5 to 6. Here the duration is 5. In this way, you have to construct the network diagram by connecting the activities. Clear? So the next step is to calculate the EST and LFT, that is earliest starting time and latest finish time. So I have drawn boxes right here. So in the first box is for EST and the second is for LFT. This earliest starting time and latest finishing time. Okay, or else instead of boxes, you can also write it as E1, L1 or E2, L2, E3, L3. It's your choice, students. Okay, I have drawn boxes right here. So first step is, first we have to calculate the EST. So this is EST calculation is also known as forward pass calculation. So the earliest starting time to start the first activity is always 0. Okay, so from 0 we have to start the activity. So the first activity is 1 to 2. Okay, so I'm going from the activity 1 to 2. So the EST of first event is 0. So 0 plus 10, that is 10. Okay, next activity is 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3, the duration is 24 hours. To reach the third event, there are two ways. You can go from 1, 2, 3 or 2, 2, 3. Okay, so from 1, 2, 3, the value is 0 plus 24. Okay, the value is 0 plus 24, that is 24. From 2 to 3, the value is, here the EST is 10 plus 9. Okay, that is 19. 10 plus 9 is 19. We need to take the maximum value. From these two values, the maximum value is 24. Okay, right, 24 right here. Clear? Next activity is 2 to 3. It's completed, 24. Next, 2 to 4. 2 to 4, the EST here is 10. 10 plus 16, that is 26. Okay, sorry, 10 plus 16 is 26. Next, we have completed 2 to 4. Next is 2 to 5, 3 to 5 and 4 to 5. To reach the fifth event, there are three ways. You can go from 2 to 5, 4 to 5 and 3 to 5. Okay, so first let's see 2 to 5. Okay, 2 to 5, the value will come. The EST here is 10 and the duration is 10. So 10 plus 10 is 20. Next is 3 to 5. In the third event, the EST is 24 plus the duration is 9. 24 plus 9 is 33. Next is 4 to 5. 4 to 5, here the EST is 26. Duration is 4. 26 plus 4 is 30. From these three values, which one is the maximum, students? 33. So here we have to take the maximum value, that is 33. Clear? Okay. To reach the fifth event, there are three ways. In that three ways, we need to take the maximum value. Okay. And next, the last event is 5 to 6. Here the EST is 33. 33 plus 5 is 38. Clear? So this is known as forward pass calculation. Okay. Next is, we need to find the LFT, that is latest finishing time. We need to come backward from the activity 6. Okay, here the EST is 38, LFT will also be 38. Okay, so coming from the last activity, 5 to 6, this you have to come from 6 to 5. So 38 minus 5, that is 33. For EST, you have to add the duration. Next, well, coming to the LFT, you have to reduce or you have to subtract the activity time. Okay, so 38 minus 5 is 33. Next, 4 to 5. Okay, next we are calculating the activity LFT from 5 to 4, that is 33 minus 4. Here the LFT of fifth event is 33. 33 minus 4, that is 29. Okay, next, 3 to 5. Okay, 3 to 5. So here the LFT is 33. So 33 minus 9, that is 24. Okay, I have to subtract it. 33 minus 9, that is 24. Next, 2 to 5. To reach the second activity, there are three ways, students. From second, there are three events, fourth, fifth, and third event. Okay, to reach the two, there are three events, third, fourth and fifth. So first let's go from 2 to 5. Okay, here the LFT is 33 and the activity time is 10. So 33 minus 10 is 23. Okay, next, let's go from 2 to 4. Here the LFT is 29 minus 16. Here 29 minus 16 is 13. Next, from 2 to 3, in third event, the LFT is 24. 24 minus 9 is 15. Okay, so in these three values, which one is the minimum value, students? The minimum one is 3. Okay, the minimum value is 13. You need to take here 13. Okay, in case of EST, we have to take the maximum one. In case of LFT, we have to take the minimum one. Clear, everyone, students? So while coming to 2, there are three activities, 3, 4 and 5. From in that, you have to take the minimum activity time. Okay, that is 13. Next is we have completed 2 to 3, 2 to 4 and 2 to 5. Next is 1 to 3, 1 to 2. To reach the first activity, there are two ways. You can go from 2 and 3. Okay. So in the second, let's go from 1 to 3. The LFT is from 1 to 3, the LFT is 24. 24 minus 24 is 0. Next, 13 minus 10. From 1 to 2, that is 13 minus 10 is 3. Okay. So in this, the minimum value is 0. Okay. Here the minimum value is 0. So this, by this way we have to calculate the EFT, EST and LFT. So this calculation is known as backward pass calculation. While going to EST, you have to add by taking the maximum value, and while coming to the LFT, we have to subtract it and by taking the minimum value. Okay. And at the first activity, students, both the EST and LFT should be 0. Then only your answer is said to be right. Okay. Next step is to find the critical path. To reach from 1 to 6th activity, how many paths we have to determine. Okay, first I am taking 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 5 and 5 to 6. Okay, this is the first path. Next, 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 6. This is the second. Next, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 6. The third one. And next, 1 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 6. So these are the four paths we have taken from this diagram. So we have to add the duration: 1 to 2, 10, 2 to 4, 16, 4 to 5, 4, 5 to 6 is 5. The duration is 35 weeks. The same way we need to find the duration. So in this duration, the maximum duration is for the last path, that is 1 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 6. So this is the maximum duration is 38 weeks. This is the critical path. Okay, you need to highlight this part, students. By adding two lines. So this is the critical path in this solution. So next we have find out the critical path is 1 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 6. Next is project completion time. The project completion time is 38 weeks. So the total project completion time is 38 weeks. Okay, but in this way we need to construct the network diagram. Clear everyone? So next problem, a project schedule has the following characteristic. So these are the activities given and the time in days is given. So they are asking us to calculate, construct a network diagram, and next compute the earliest event time, that is earliest starting time and as well as earliest finishing time, and next latest event time, that is latest starting time and latest finishing time. Okay, next determine the critical path and total project duration, and next compute the total float and free float for each activity. Clear? So this is a problem number 2. So first step is you have to construct a network diagram. So let's start. First activity is 1 to 2. So from 1 there are two activities, 1 to 2, 1 to 3. 1 to 2 and next 1 to 3. Okay, next 2 to 4, 3 to 4. To reach the fourth event, there are two ways, from 2 to 4, 3 to 4. So this is the fourth event, 2 to 4, next 3 to 4. Okay, next 3 to 5. Next 4 to 9. 4 to 9. okay. Next is 5 to 6, 5 to 7. Clear. From 5, there are two activities. Five to six. Next, 5 to 7. Okay. Next one is 6 to 8 and 7 to 8. So 6 and 7 are meeting at the 8th event. So 8, 6 to 8, 7 to 8. Next. Next is 8 to 10, 9 to 10. And the last one is 9 to 10. So connect these two. Okay. So this is our network diagram. So write the duration here, students. For 1 to 2 is 4. Next 1. 2 to 4 is 1, 3 to 4, 1, 3 to 5, 6, 4 to 9 is 5, 5 to 6, 4, 8, 6 to 8 is 1, next 7 to 8, 2, 2 to 10, 5, and next 9 to 10 is 7 days. Okay, students, go in neat way by using scale and pencil. Okay. This is a network diagram. Next step is to compute EST and LFT. So starting with the EST, the earliest starting time of first event will be 0. Next, 1 to 2. So 1 to 2, EST is 0. 0 plus the activity time is 4. 0 plus 4 is 4. Okay. Next, 1 to 3. Here the EST is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay. Next, 2 to 4. To reach the 4th event, there are two ways, 2 to 4, 3 to 4, 2 to 4, 3 to 4. So here the EST is 4 plus 1 is 5, here 1 plus 1 is 2. So the maximum one is 5, 4 plus 1 is 5, okay? You need to take the maximum value. Next, 3 to 5, 3 to 5, here the EST is 1, activity time is 6, so 1 plus 6 is 7. Next, 4 to 9. Here the EST is 5, 5 plus 5 is 10. Okay. Next, you need to check the number of ways. Based on the ways, students, you have to take the maximum value. Okay. Next, 5 to 6. 5 to 6, here EST is 7, 7 plus 4 is 11. Okay. Next, 5 to 7. Here the EST is 7 and the activity time is 8. So, 7 plus 8 is 15. Next, 5 to 7 is also over. 6 to 8, 7 to 8. To reach the 8th activity, there are two ways. From 6 to 7, 7 to 8. So here the EST is 11 plus 1, 12. Here the EST is 15 plus 2, that is 17. So the maximum one is 15 plus 2, that is 17. Okay. Next, 7 to 8, 8 to 10. And 9 to 10, two ways are given. So from 9 to 10, 10 plus 7 is 17. Here 17 plus 5 is 22. So the maximum one is 22. Clear? So this calculation is known as forward pass calculation. Okay? Next we need to find the LFT. We have to come backward. Here we have to take the LFT, that is 22. Okay, equal to the EST. So the last activity is 9 to 10. So from 10 to 9. So 22 minus 7 is 15. Okay. We need to subtract the LFT minus activity time. 22 minus 7 is 15. Next, 10 to 8. We are coming backward from 10 to 8. So here the LFT is 22 minus 5 is 17. Okay. Next, 8 to 7. Okay, so here LFT is 17, 17 minus 2 is 15. Next, 6 to 8, that is 17 minus 1 is 16. Okay, next, 5 to 7, and next is 5 to 6. To come to 5, there are two ways, that is from 7 and 6, 5 to 6 and 5 to 7. So we have to take here, first take the 5 to 6, 16 minus 4 is 12, and next 15 minus 8, 15 minus 8 is 7. Okay, so here two values, 12, 7, so here the minimum one is 7, we need to take here 7. Okay, so the next one is 4 to 9. From 9 to 4 we have to come, 15 minus 5 is 10. Okay, next one is 3 to 5, 3 to 4. From 3 there are two activity students, 3 to 4, 3 to 5, so we can come from 5 and 4. Okay, so first take 3 to 4, here the LFT is 10, 10 minus 1 is 9, here the LFT is in the 5th activity, the LFT is 7, 7 minus 6 is 1, so the minimum 1 is 1. Okay, next, we have completed these two, 3 to 5, 3 to 4, next, 2 to 4, here the LFT is 10, and the activity time is 1, so 10 minus 1 is 9, next, 1 to 3, 1 to 2. To reach the first activity, there are two ways, 1 to 2, 1 to 3. So 1 minus 1 is 0, and next 9 minus 4 is 5. So the minimum 1 is 0. So 1 minus 1 is 0. So this is the backward pass calculation. Okay, we have to take the minimum value in case of LFT and maximum value in case of EST. Okay, here both the EST and LFT should be 0. Clear? Next step is to compute the earliest event time, that is EST and EFT, and latest event time, that is LST and LFT. Okay, and next step is we need to find the critical path and total project duration. Along with that, we also need to find out the total and free float. So all these can be calculated by this table. Okay, so here students, in this table I have taken the activity given in the question, next normal time, which is nothing but the time given in days. Next we have find out the EST, EFT, LST, LFT, that is EST here is earliest starting time, earliest finishing time, latest starting time, latest finishing time, total flow time, free float. Okay, so first we need to take all the activities given in the question right here. Next, the normal time, that is the duration given in the question, we need to write here. Next, we need to write the earliest starting time which we had calculated in the network diagram. Okay, here in the network diagram we had already find out the EST and LFT, that is earliest starting time and latest finishing time. So next we need to write the earliest starting time which we have calculated in this network diagram. So EST for the activity 1, first activity is 1 to 2, the EST is 0. Okay, we have taken 0 as EST on 1 to 2 activity, that is 0 plus 4 is 4. So here EST for 1 to 2 activity is 0. Okay, next activity is 1 to 3, here also the EST is 0. Okay, here EST is 0. Next, coming to the 2 to 4 activity, here the EST is 4, so I have taken 4 here. Next, 3 to 4 activity, here the EST is 1, so 1. Next, 3 to 5 activity, EST is again 1, so 1. Next, 4 to 9, the EST is 5. Okay, next, 5 to 6 activity, the EST is 7. Okay, 5 to 7 activity, EST is also 7. Next, 6 to 8 activity, EST is 11. Next, 7 to 8 activity, EST is 15. Next, 8 to 10, 17. Next, 9 to 10 is 10. Okay, this is the earliest starting time which we have computed already in the network diagram. Okay, next step is to find out the EFT, that is earliest finishing time. So the formula of calculating EFT is EFT earliest finishing time is equal to EST plus activity time. Okay, EST plus activity time. So EST here is 0, 0 plus 4, 4, 0 plus 1, 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 1 plus 1, 2, 1 plus 6, 7, so on. Okay, in this way we need to find the earliest finishing time. Clear everyone? EST we need to find from the network diagram. Next EFT, the formula is EST plus activity time. Okay, next step is to find the LST and LFT. In the network diagram itself, we have already computed LFT. First take this column, students, LFT. Coming to the LFT, we have calculated in the network diagram itself. So coming to the first activity, 1 to 2, the LFT is 9. Okay, LFT is 9. Next, coming to the second activity, 1 to 3, 1 to 3 LFT is 1. Okay, so I have taken 1 here. Next, 2 to 4 activity, the LFT is 10. Okay, at the ending point, the end of the activity, the LFT should be taken. Next, 3 to 4, the LFT is again 10. Next, 3 to 5, LFT is 7. Next, 4 to 9, LFT is 15. Next, 5 to 6, LFT is 16. Next, 5 to 7, LFT is 15. Next, 6 to 8, LFT is 17. Next, 7 to 8, LFT is again 17. Next, 8 to 10, LFT is 22. Next, 9 to 10, the LFT is 22. Okay, so the LFT we have already computed in the network diagram. Next we need to find the LST, that is latest starting time. The formula to calculate LST is LFT minus activity time. Okay, LFT minus activity time. Clear? So 9 minus 4, 5. Okay, 1 minus 1, 0. LFT minus activity time is LST. So 9 minus 4, 5. 1 minus 1, 0. 10 minus 1, 9. 10 minus 1, 9. 7 minus 6, 1. 15 minus 5, 10. So on. Okay, in this way we need to find the LST. Clear everyone, students? For EFT, the formula is EST plus activity time. For LST, the formula is LFT minus activity time. Okay? So the next step is to compute the total float. The formula of total float is equal to LST minus EST. So here LST is 5 and EST is 0. 5 minus 0, 5. Next, 0 minus 0, 0. 9 minus 4, 5. 9 minus 1, 8. 1 minus 1, 0, and so on. By using this formula, you need to compute the total float. So the total float is equal to LST minus EST. And the next step is to compute the free float. The formula of free float is, students, free float is equal to LFT minus EFT of minus total float. Okay, so here LFT is 9 minus EFT is 4 minus total float is 5. So 9 minus 4 is 5, 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. Clear everyone? Here the free float is 0. The same way we need to compute the free float of each and every activity. So next is, here the LFT is 1, EFT is 1, 1 minus 1, 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. Next, here the LFT is 10, 10 minus 5, 5, 5 minus 5 is 0. Okay, by applying this formula, you need to compute the free float. Clear everyone, students? In this way, we have to find out the EST, EFT, LST, LFT, total float and free float. Okay, clear? So the next step is to find the critical path. The critical path is determined the help of total float. So we have to identify the zeros in the total float by giving a circle to those zeros. So here is 1 0, next here is also another 0, next 0 0. You need to give a circle to these zeros. So these zeros represents the critical path. Okay, so the zero comes at 1 to 3 activity, next 3 to 5 activity, next 0 comes at 5 to 7 activity, next at 7 to 8, next at 8 to 10. So this is the critical path. So you need to write 1 to 3, there is a 0. Total float is 0. So the critical path is 1 to 3, next 3 to 5. okay, 3 to 5. Next 0 is at 5 to 7. Next is at 7 to 8, and next is at 8 to 10. So this is the critical path. Okay students, you need to identify the zeros in the total float that represents the critical path. Okay, and the next is we need to find the project duration. So the total project duration is, students, 22. Since the time is given in days, so the total project duration is 22 days. So total project time or project duration is equal to 22 days. Clear, students? In this way you need to find out the critical path by using the total float. Okay students, so this is the problem number 2. First you need to draw a network diagram, calculate the EST and LFT. Next we need to, they are asking us to calculate the earliest event time and latest event time, that is both EST, EFT, LST and LFT. Next total float and free float by using the formulas we need to find out. And next in the total float we need to identify the zeros to find the critical path. So the critical path is 1 to 3, 3 to 5, 5 to 7, 7 to 8 and 8 to 10. You need to highlight this in the network diagram. 1 to 3, just draw 2 lines. Next 3 to 5, next 5 to 7, 7 to 8, 8 to 10. Okay. So the next problem is on PERT. The question is, a small project involves 7 activity and their time estimates are listed in the following table. So these are the activities given and these are the estimated duration. Okay. Here these 3 times are given, that is optimistic, most likely and pessimistic time. So optimistic time is nothing but, students, it is the smallest time taken to complete the activity if everything goes well. That time is known as optimistic time. Next is most likely time is nothing but the normal time that an activity would take. That time is known as most likely time. Next is pessimistic time is nothing but the longest time that an activity would take if everything goes wrong. Okay, that time is known as pessimistic time. Clear, students? So here optimistic time is denoted as TO. Next most likely time is TM. Next pessimistic time is TP. Clear? So optimistic is nothing but the smallest time taken to complete an activity. The normal time taken by an activity is known as most likely time. And the longest time taken by an activity if something or everything goes wrong. So that is known as pessimistic time. So students, they are asking us to draw a network diagram in activities of project, find the expected duration for each activity and calculate the project duration. After that, they are asking us to identify the critical path. So let's start a solution. I have taken the activity. Next, TO is nothing but the optimistic time. TM is nothing but the most likely time. TP is pessimistic time. So after taking this data from the question, the next step is to find the expected duration, that is TE. So that to find out that expected duration, the formula is, students, TE is equal to TO plus 4 into TM plus TP by 6. You need to apply this formula for each and every activity to find out the expected duration, that is T. Here TO is optimistic time, TM is most likely time and TP is pessimistic time. So taking the first activity 1 to 2, the TO here is 1 plus 4 into TM is 1 plus TP here is 7 by 6. So 1 plus 4, 4 plus 7, that is 1 plus 4 is 5, 5 plus 7 is 12 by 6, 6 into 2 is 12. So here expected duration is 2. Okay. So here expected duration is 2. Clear? Next, in the same way, by applying this formula, you need to find the expected duration for next activity. Here, the next activity TO is 1, 1 plus 4 into 4, 16, 16 plus 7. 16 plus 1 is 17, 17 plus 7 is 24, 24 by 6 is 4, 6 4s are 24. Okay, this way you need to find the expected duration. Clear, students? The next one is 3, 1, 6, 5, 7. So apply the formula in the same manner and find out the expected duration. Okay, so we have calculated the expected duration. The next step is to draw a network diagram. So in same in the previous problem, we have constructed a network diagram. In the same manner, we have to draw a network diagram, students. 1 to 2, 1 to 2. From 1, there are 3 activities, 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4. So 1 to 2, 1 to 3 and 1 to 4. Next, 2 to 5, 3 to 5. At 5, 2 activities are ending, 2 and 3. 2 to 5, 3 to 5. Next, 4 to 6, 5 to 6. 4 to 6 and 5 to 6. So I have constructed the network diagram. So you need to write the duration, that is expected duration. 1 to 2 is 2. Next, 1 to 3 is 4. Next, 1 to 4 is 3. Next, 2 to 5, 1. 3 to 5, 6. Next, 4 to 6, 5. And the last one is 5 to 6 is 7. Okay. So, I have constructed the network diagram. Next, we need to find the EST and LFT for each and every activity. Okay. Find out in the EST and LFT, starting with the 0. So 1 to 2 activity, 0 plus 2 is 2. Next 1 to 3, 0 plus 4, here the EST is 4. Next 0 plus 3 is 3. Okay, next we have completed 1 to 2, 1 to 3 and 1 to 4. Next is 2 to 5. To reach the fifth event, there are two ways, 2 to 5, 3 to 5. Okay, so here the EST is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3. Next, here the EST is 4, 4 plus 6 is 10. So 3 and 10, the maximum one is 10. So here the EST is 10. So 2 plus 1 is 3 and 4 plus 6 is 10. So we have to take the maximum one, that is 10. So we have completed 2 to 5, 3 to 5. Next, 4 to 6. To reach the 6th activity, there are two ways, 4 to 6, 5 to 6, 4 to 6, 5 to 6. So here the EST is 10, 10 plus 7 is 17. Here the EST is 3, 3 plus 5 is 8. So the maximum one is 17. Okay, clear? Next step is to find the LFT. We need to come backward, which is also known as backward pass calculation. Here the LFT starts by taking LFT here as 17, that is equal to EST. Okay, so the last activity is 5 to 6, so we have to come from 6 to 5. So 17 minus 7 is 10. Next, 6 to 4. So 6 to 4, 17 minus 5 is 12. Okay, next 3 to 5, that is 5 to 3. 10 minus 6 is 4. Next, 2 to 5. 10 minus 1 is 9. Next, the activities 1 to 4, 1 to 3 and 1 to, from 1, 3 activities are coming, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, we need to find the LFT, and from that 3 activities we need to take the minimum one. So 9 from first coming from 4 to 1, that is 4 to 1, the LFT is 12. 12 minus 3 is 9. Next coming from 1 to 3, 4 minus 4 is 0. Next, 1 to 2, that is from 2 to 1, 9 minus 2 is 7. So here the minimum one is, we have to take the minimum one, that is 0. So here LFT should be 0, then only our answer is said to be correct. Okay students, we have to take the minimum one, that is 0. Clear? By this way we have calculated EST and LFT. Okay, so we need to find out the various possible paths from the network diagram to reach from the starting and ending event. Okay, so first path is 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 6. This is the first, this is the second and this is the third, that is 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 6. Next, 1 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 6. Next path, possible path is 1 to 4, 4 to 6. Okay students, you need to add the duration. 1 to 2, 2 plus 1 plus 7, that is 10. Duration is given in weeks. It is 10 weeks. Here is the 17 weeks. Here is the 8 weeks. So the maximum weeks, the maximum time taken in this path. So this path is known as critical path. So 17 is the maximum. So the critical path is 1 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 6. Okay, next, the project duration, the total project duration time is 17 weeks. So project duration टाइम इज 17 वीक्स. क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स? सो यू नीड टू हाईलाइट द क्रिटिकल पाथ बाय ड्रॉइंग टू लाइन स्टूडेंट्स. दिस इज अ क्रिटिकल पाथ 1 to 3, 3 to 5 एंड 5 to 6. सो ड्रॉ अनदर लाइन फॉर दिस 5 and 5 to 6. Okay, so this is the problem on part. Okay students, we need to find the expected duration, and next after finding the expected duration, the same manner we need to construct a network diagram, and we have to find out the critical path. Okay, so I hope you guys understood the topic, and let me know if you have any doubt.